guess one of the biggest lies that I believed growing up was from people that were older than me. That told me that, you know, fullest joy and satisfaction in life came from, you know, pleasure, power, and possessions. Believing that, you know, indulging in pleasures unlimited now would lead to greatest satisfaction or greatest fulfillment in life. You know, and I found out later that those were lies. You know what I'm saying? That to think that serving God or following him would mean that I'm missing out on something, you know, something awesome in life, was a complete lie. You know what I'm saying? I think that the truth that I found was the greatest pleasures and the greatest lasting joy and satisfaction is found in being restored to relationship with God through Christ. And so when I discovered that truth, I realized, man, I made so much out of pleasure and power and possessions. I made them, they're good things, but they're not God things, and I made them that because I believed that they could do what only God could do, which was bring true joy, true satisfaction. So that was probably the biggest lie that I believed growing up. You need something real. Yeah. Well, I think God's word in its entirety has helped me navigate truth and lies in all things, right? So on a day-to-day basis, I'm wrestling with what is truth, which it essentially is God's word, right? And what is lies? What does my sin nature want to believe and trust in above God and his word and his commandments? So every day I'm wrestling with that, and in different situations, it's different things. It's like only full satisfaction can come in Jesus. So stuff like Psalms 37:4 says, delight yourself in the Lord and he'll give you the desires of your heart. And I remember, like, okay, I need to be pursuing delight in the Lord. And then he'll give me the desires of my heart, which will be aligned with his desires. As a missionary in hip-hop, we're coming in and we're surveying the land and saying, ah, okay, here are things that the culture exalts wrongly. These are the lies that are being perpetuated. Now, in our music, we want to fight against that. That's why I have records like Fool's Gold, right? Fool's Gold is talking about, man, you... I can't front, I like nice kicks and new clothes. I like giving old school records new flows. I like the money that I make when I do shows. But when I abuse those, they fools go. Now let me tell you what I mean. I could make something good a God thing. Turning my wants into needs. Holding on to perishing means as supreme. It seems people want pleasure for a season instead of seeking the God who's eternally pleasing. For some reason I thought that I wouldn't be lonely if I had women all on me. I couldn't buy joy with the paper. My good deeds never bought God's favor. I found my currency faulty. I'm so glad that the Christ came and bought me. That whole verse was contrasting. I thought this, but this is the truth. I thought I wouldn't be lonely if I had women on me. That was a lie. You know what I'm saying? Like, I had that and was still lonely and empty because it didn't fulfill me the way I thought it would. You know, I thought I could buy joy with money. We see that situation is not true all the time. We see millionaires committing suicide. How does that happen? You have all the money you want. You buy whatever you want. Obviously, that money couldn't. It's a good thing, but it's not a God thing. It can't fulfill you the way that God can. So we believe lies like that all the time. And I think a lot of our objective in the music is to expose the lies and bring people truth.